Task Force Commander, Command Sergeant Major, Lieutenant Colonel Stephen P. McGinnis, Command Sergeant Major, Curtis A. Reed. Welcome to today's change of responsibilities. This morning, First Sergeant Aaron Moss will relinquish responsibility of the Headquarters and Headquarters Company to First Sergeant Clifford Stump. The reviewing officer for today's ceremony is Captain Dustin Lawrence, Commander of HHC Task Force Ventilator. The soldiers and armies throughout the world have conducted ceremonies to commemorate victory over an enemy, to honor their heroes, to celebrate special occasions, or to pay homage to their fallen comrades. These ceremonies add color and pageantry to military life. Today's ceremony is a reflection of procedures practiced since the dawn of our nation. Today's ceremony is derived from our Army's first manual of ceremonies, the Blue Book, written by General Friedrich von Steuben. The ceremony that you are about to see includes honors to the nation, change of responsibility, remarks, and a conclusion. The centralized presence of our national colors in the missile, in peace and in conflict. Unit colors serve to mark the location of an organization headquarters. When removed, it is done under guard. This is more than tradition. It is solemn recognition of all the unit members that have gone before. As such, the task of guarding unit colors is an honor given to only the finest of soldiers. At this time, a single red rose is being presented to Mrs. Stephanie Moss on behalf of the soldiers and families of HHC Task Force 138. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the invocation by the Task Force 138 Chaplain, Captain Matthew Verstel, and remain standing for the playing of our national anthem.
Urge you to bow your head as we pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we are here to celebrate and honor the backbone of the United States Army, and to thank you for First Sergeant Marn as he ends his tenure as a HHC First Sergeant. Thank you for the privilege of working with him and for the lives he has impacted in Havoc Company. Lord, we ask that you bless him as he brings his expertise, his humor, and his wisdom to the three shop. And as the responsibility of leadership now falls to First Sergeant Stein, we ask that you grant him wisdom to lead, courage to do the right thing, and strength to accomplish the mission. May his time as Havoc 7 be of one of blessing to him and for all of the dogs of war. We ask this in your holy name. Amen.
The change of responsibility is a simple yet traditional event that is rich with symbolism and heritage. The key to the ceremony is the passing of the company galvan. The very soul of a military unit is symbolized in the colors under which it fights, for they represent not only the lineage and honor of the unit, but also the loyalty and unity of its soldiers. The custodian of the galvan is the company first sergeant, who is the senior enlisted soldier in the unit and the principal advisor to the command. The commander of troops now passes the guidon to our sergeant. Sergeant Marr now passes the guy on to Captain Lawrence, signifying his last official act as Company First Sergeant and gratitude for the opportunity to care for the soldiers and families of the company. Captain Lawrence now passes the guy on to First Sergeant Stein, charging him with the responsibility for the unit as the new Company First Sergeant. Assumption of responsibility for First Sergeant Clifford Stein, let it be known that effective April 7th, 2020, that you assume responsibility as the Company First Sergeant. First Sergeant Stein now passes the guidon to the commander of troops, symbolizing his dedication and commitment to the soldiers and families of the company. Ladies and gentlemen, the commander, HOC, Task Force 128, Captain Dustin Lawrence.
Colonel McGinnis, Command Sergeant Major Reed, families, friends, and guests tuning in via Facebook. Thank you for attending or viewing. This is a very different change of responsibility. Gone is the formation of wire-tight warriors that would normally stand before us. Replaced instead with a flurry of rising emoticons, hearts, thumbs ups, pure faces, I'm sure. First of all, we'll be reviewing later, so keep it professional. We are, of course, here today to pay homage to one outgoing senior non-commissioned officer and usher in another. As with so many events in our daily lives, we, of course, ask the question, was this necessary? Of course, every interaction these days involves risk. Did we have to conduct this ceremony? Well, we certainly could not put our soldiers at risk by placing everyone in a formation. We sanitized and made sure to take the proper hygienic measures for passing the guide on. Without the formation, though, this just isn't the same. But in reality, this is perfect. The nature of an HHC First Sergeant is that he is a steward of the most diverse group of soldiers in the unit. In battle, he doesn't move forward with the scouts. He's not managing the aid station. He doesn't jump the talk. He doesn't oversee the mortar firing point. No, the most important thing an HHC First Sergeant does is prepare their soldiers for those critical moments. And it just so happens we find ourselves in a critical moment. And preparing soldiers is what First Sergeant Warren has been doing and does best. Every NCOIC in this digital formation will certainly attest to this. At the root of every decision or guidance from First Sergeant Marin has been the soldier at the lowest level. Napoleon was said to have a keen perspective into the ranks of his formation, a sort of directed telescope that allowed him to understand what decisions would mean at the lowest level. I don't know if I have this ability, but for the past 7 months I had something better. I had First Sergeant Marin by my side. He is that telescope. And what's most impressive is not just that First Sergeant Martin maintained this ability with a 300-plus soldier formation, but that he maintained that perspective when his formation burgeoned to nearly 600 when the task force deployed to West Point. Nevertheless, First Sergeant Martin never hesitated to pull a soldier or an NCO, or for that matter, an officer, behind a closed door and offer them real leadership. A man this focused on the well-being of others can only be accompanied by a powerhouse family. Steph, Jaden, Brianna, thank you so much for your contributions to this team, whether leading an FRG or bringing soldiers into your home in their time of need. You're all leaders. But now,
thanks, Jaden.
But now the guide on has passed, the responsibility has changed. We welcome a new First Sergeant, his lovely fiance, Ashley. She too is contributing to the national response to this pandemic. And if we had a formation here, I would pause and ask for a round of applause. It was no accident that we welcomed a seasoned veteran to the seat, an artilleryman who proved himself leading the best damn battery in the Army. First Sergeant Stein, I genuinely cannot wait to work with you. The soldiers and leaders here at HHC are spoiled. And finally, soldiers of Havoc Company, stay ready. This pandemic is showing us that this world can be a fragile place. As a certain leader rightly reminds us, there's a C-130 inbound from Lawson Army Airfield, and you're on the manifest. Rock of the Marne, hunt with the pack, cry havoc, and let slip the dogs of war.
Ladies and gentlemen, first arm lock. Guests, fellow commanders and first lines, family, friends, and soldiers and leaders of HHC. Thank you for attending today's Chain of Responsibility. First, I would like to thank God for giving me the strength and ability to serve my country and placing me in positions to work with a diverse group of such incredible soldiers. Steph, Brianna, Jaden, thank you for your love and support prior to and throughout our career. Yes, our career. Because without you, none of this would be possible. I can't count the number of times I thought of you alone has given me the strength to drive on. I love you all with all my heart.
Love you, Dad.
Lieutenant Colonel McGinnis, Sergeant Major Walker, Command Sergeant Major Reed, thank you for giving me the opportunity to lead, manage, and serve in this outstanding organization. It has been an honor serving the soldiers of HHC and observing soldiers and leaders alike accomplish daily missions with pride, purpose, and professionalism. Your mentorship and guidance, for however short or extenuating, will have a lasting impact on me as a soldier and as a man. Captain Clark, Captain Howard, Captain Lawrence, my Ranger buddies, Lieutenant Routon and Lieutenant Bowles, thank you for your leadership, teamwork, and genuine concern for the soldiers we have led. I thank you for always weighing in my and the team's recommendations prior to finalizing decisions, always placing the mission, the soldiers' development, and their health and welfare first, for bringing our families together on occasions to further strengthen our relationship and ultimately your friendship, and lead others with the intent that they will someday be better than we are, which shouldn't be too difficult for my soldiers. I'd be naive to think I have supported or bestowed more knowledge among you than you have supported and shared with me. I thank you all for always pulling together and collectively working through any given situation. During my tenure, we have experienced some of the highest of highs and lowest of lows. From dominating sister elements during Marne Week and leading with almost every trophy, to conducting memorial services, one of which for our very own Sergeant Panessa, who is gone, but whom we will never forget. Given all of our situations and experiences, we have demonstrated we are more than just a team. We are a family. I will never be further than an email, text, or phone call away. I can only hope to serve with each of you again in some capacity. Until then, continue to be the subject matter experts and professionals that enable the next generation to be better than we are. Rock of the Marne, home with the pack, Dogs of War, Havoc 7, signing off. Ladies and gentlemen, the HHC Task Force 128 Infantry Company First Sergeant Stein. Good morning, distinguished guests, family, friends, and soldiers of HHC. First and foremost, I'd like to thank God. Without him, I wouldn't be here today, and I definitely wouldn't be the person I am today. Ashley, thank you for your love and endless support as I take on this new and challenging role. Even though I know you would love to have been here today, with your job and travel ban, it just wasn't possible. Without you, none of this would be possible. I love you. Thank you, Lieutenant Colonel McGinnis, Command Sergeant Major Reed, for giving me the opportunity to lead the soldiers of this great company. Thank you, Echo Battery, for all the soldiers and leaders that I have had the privilege of working with this past year. I would like to take a moment and thank First Sergeant Marr, whose leadership and dedication to the unit for the past year will not be forgotten. First Sergeant Marr is truly professional, who will be successful in all his future endeavors. Thank you, First Sergeant, for allowing me to inherit such a successful company. It is important to maintain continuity, but just as important to welcome change. I look forward to serving alongside Captain Lawrence and enhancing the proficiency of HHC. HHC has a history of great leadership, and I will continue that history as the First Sergeant. I will be a 360-degree leader. I will lead south to the soldiers under my care. I will lead north by influencing those with authority over me. I will lead east and west, impacting my peers. But most importantly, I will stay humble, yet vigilant, and maintain my own compass in the old center. Rock of the Mars, home with the pack, dogs of war. Havoc 7, signing off.
For the first time, First Sergeant Stein takes charge of the company. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and join in the singing of the Marne song, the Dog Day Soldier, and the Army song.
Sir.
This concludes today's ceremony. Thank you for attending. Black Lions.